the desert southwest.
All right, so we were talking a lot about rain just a moment ago. Mm-hmm. Obviously, the River Valley completely going underwater at one point a few weeks ago because of that historic flooding.
Late May
from the Arkansas River. So the city of Fort Smith has taken extra steps to move flood survivors closer to the life they lived before that historic flooding. Fox 24's Carissa Bustamante in Fort Smith with a look at how city council members voted to make hundreds of homeowners' lives easier, but it could also come at the cost if those restoring their homes aren't cautious.
Rebuilding the River Valley doesn't come without a hefty price tag. Altogether, the city of Fort Smith estimates it'll cost flood victims $40,000 to get their homes back in order. It's an extra burden City Director Neil Martin says shouldn't fall on the shoulders of people who have already lost so much.
They're already having to deal with being displaced from their homes, already having to deal with memories being destroyed, homes being destroyed. And so we wanted to at least provide some relief to them by waiving the fees.
The city waiving building permit and city inspection fees connected with repairing structures destroyed in the historic floods. Those who have already gone through the permitting process will be refunded by the city. Martin says Fort Smith has worked with FEMA and other agencies to compile a list of over 250 people who qualify to have their fees waived.
At the peak of the flooding, the water was so high you could barely see the top of this mailbox. But now the water is gone. Residents are rebuilding.
Now hopefully FEMA insurance will be able to come through on the rest of that.
That's where Javier Cantinko with the Small Business Administration comes in. Once residents apply for FEMA, they can refer to SBA for further assistance.
So far in the state of Arkansas, we have approved 52 home loans for a total of just under $4 million.
SBA is here to get flood survivors back on their feet by providing low-interest federal disaster loans, which Cantinko takes pride in.
We cannot help everybody, but if we can get help some individuals, it gives you a great feeling.
You can find Cantinko and his team inside the FEMA Disaster Recovery Center in the Central Mall, along with other organizations ready to help in whatever way they can.
I've toured some of these homes, and I've walked in them, I've talked to the people, and they're going through a lot. I mean, it's nerve-wracking to lose your house. And so this hopefully provides a little bit of comfort for them so that they can move forward with the rebuilding, move forward with their lives.
That was our Clarissa Bustamante reporting. We're certainly hopeful that they can move forward after that historic flooding.